Mooney, cold and dark. In getting into the cockpit, putting on headset. Check the clock. Clock is wound. Clock is correct. All right, autopilot off. Set my seat. Get out my checklist. I'm not going to set my seatbelt as I would normally because that will get in the way of the cameras and mess things up. Weather density, altitude, weight imbalance, yep, performance requirements, yep, flight plan, file, airport, air papers, aero, that's in the back, gear lever down, master on, gear light green, gear light is not red, the red tests. Not going to extend the flaps. Feet of heat test, I would have done that already in this pre-flight. Stall indicator, I would have done that in the pre-flight. Lights, check that. Fuel gauges, yep. Fuel selector. And I already, so those are all the pre-flight items. I have selected the right tank. And the caps, drains, vents. Okay, I've done the exterior summary. Fuel proper tank is on the right tank. Alternate static. Don't have one. Power boost off. ELT armed, it always is. Seat back track locked. Circuit breakers. Check. Pedal test. Avionics off. Autopilot off. Cow flaps open. Mixture rich. Okay, so now we're going to do the engine start. Keys in. Throttle to half. Fuel pump. Get fuel pressure. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004, since it's a little bit of a warm day. Throttle to idle, and then just crack it just a tiny bit. Run the beacon. Clear prop!
GPS, we're going to let the Apollo initialize because it will initialize by itself. We're checking all the outputs. Lamps. That's an important one to check. Okay, so the Apollo is happy. It's messaging, basically, it's just saying it can't compute anything because I haven't given it anything to compute. I go to map. And that's done. So now I start checking other stuff. How's my oil temperature? Oil temperature is at 87, that's fine. Oil pressure is still in the green. Now I start doing other stuff. Mechanics on and set. So I now check my date. The date is in the future. I am doing this at the end of August 2021. So that's in the future, that's correct. I can now check this, which I'll have a whole another video on. I check the fuel on board. Yeah, that's probably okay. Hit okay. And it's indicating my airport, which means my memory card is working. So I make sure that this is the CTAF. My next frequency will be, let's say I'm going to south to Atlanta, so that'll be 133.6, I think. So that's fine. This is a local AWOS, so I'll leave that. Oil temperature is now at 92. I'll set up my navigation. And right now I'm just waiting. I'm just letting things run. Stock oil temperature is now up into the green arc. Oil temperature here is 95. The amperage, so we're getting 14.1 volts off of the alternator. And the charging is down to three amps, which means that we had a super fast start because the battery is almost already charged. I should set this to when I started the engine. Give it a couple minutes. Let's say we're just going to go to Atlanta direct. Or it's going to complain. Alright, we'll do the same thing here. ATL. Alright. Altimeter set to field elevation. 1080. Yeah, it's a nice cold day. It's 3022, I guess. All right, I set this correctly. Ammoni sits about 4 or 5 degrees nose up, so that's correct. I am heading here is 248, maybe? So, instrument set, 1, 2, 3. How's my oil temperature? 109. So we're not quite ready. This would be a good time if I was in an airport with an ATIS, then I would probably start listening to it and getting my flight plan in, other than, you know, direct to. So I would be getting my altimeter setting and getting my clearance and letting them know what I'm doing. Temperature is up to 114. My limit light is still flashing because it's below 120. Also, if I had my iPad with me, which I don't, I would be setting it up. I would be setting it up on its mount here. I would be getting it synced with the. I would be getting it synced with the Stratus, and getting all that set up. Oil temperature is now 122. My limit light has gone off. So that's fine. I usually like to wait until 140 to do my run up and head out to the runway. My oil temperature is now registering on the bar graph. I go through the cylinders. Cylinders are running about 250. Cylinder head temperature is running about 250, which is fine. They're nice and warm, but not too hot. Oh, and I will go ahead and get my flaps down in the takeoff position. Okay, that ended two pumps and that matches. I'll get my trim set. Okay, that's about right. Oil temp 132. Oops. Set the brakes. Set the engine monitor normalized mode. I wanted to be really thorough and I was on an IFR flight, I might go ahead and quick go over here and pop the alternator field light. I'll get the alt in-op light. I should get a discharge light. There we go. All right, I've got an oil temperature 142 degrees, so I'm gonna go ahead and do my run-up. Checking control freedom, down, up, elevators, up, down. Control, okay, controls free and correct. Instruments are already set. Autopilot. Yep, instruments, best power, okay. Best, rich, mixture to best power, 1800 RPM. Okay, mag check. Down 87. Down 90, perfect. prop cycle. Okay. All right, we are still, oil pressures is still in the green, oil temperature is fine, we're all happy. Vacuum is well in the green. Check the idle stop. Yep, that's fine. Alright, actual oil temperature is now at 160. Everything's in the green. And if we were actually going somewhere, now would be the time we would either call for, so lean for taxi. Now is the time that we would call for taxi, or if we were here, we would just start taxiing.